I'm Cheryl and welcome to the Sewing Room channel. Many of you have expressed interest in learning about cross stitch and or needlepoint. So I've decided I'm going to share with you my personal collection of projects I've done, projects I haven't done, and then kits that I have purchased but haven't had a chance to get started on. I'll also share with you some of my personal family pieces that were made by my mother and even a little special one made by my daughter. So let's get started. This is counted cross stitch. And if you've never looked at cross stitch fabric before, it's got little holes in it that are pretty easy to see. Even without my glasses on, I can see the holes. And what it is you bring your needle in and out of those little holes. So in counted cross stitch, you get a pattern sheet and it will tell you how many stitches to do of a particular color. And you just go across and then you come back. And you would do one of the colors as much as possible and then you would go to the next color. And all pictures are set up just a little differently. This has a lot of colors, but I've done some without. This, what I plan on doing with this is making just a little small decorative pillow out of it. This one here is one that I probably made over 30 years ago and I ran across it. It's just packed in a box and I think it's really cute. Again, I might make a little decorative pillow out of it or I might even frame it or even put it on the outside of a tote bag. And this one here, I intend to frame it. I made this about 3 years ago, and I just thought it was so beautiful. Just a lonely little chair with a vase of flowers, and I just really, really liked it. At one time, I had a chair like this that had a little wicker seat on it, and it just reminded me of the chair. On this one here, this one I also made maybe 6 years ago, and it has really pale colors on it, very subtle and soothing colors, and I was going to frame it. Now, the reason why I haven't done anything with these is we've moved about 4 or 5 times in the last 10 years, and everything keeps getting boxed up and moved. So they sort of got lost in the shuffle, and I ran across all of them. That's one of the reasons why I'm showing them to you now. This one here was in our previous house on the wall. Isn't this beautiful? I just absolutely love this one. And it was, like I said, framed on the wall in this blue fabric. I added on to the border to be a matte look on it. And I had it in a very large frame. And it was a prominent piece on the wall. It was very noticeable. It wasn't hidden in a corner, and I just absolutely love this one. Now I'm going to show you some of the projects I started and never finished. As I said, we have moved a lot, so the stack kept getting higher and higher because things would get hidden in boxes. So here is an embroidery picture I started, I don't even remember when. And I tend not to do embroidery as much because I seem to enjoy cross stitch and needlepoint more than embroidery, but a lot of people of you really enjoy it. So this one is all cream colored thread. It's just a small little piece and you can frame it if you like in one of the embroidery hoops or even turn it into a little pillow. Here is another embroidery one that I started and it has a little bit of cross stitch on it, but it's mostly embroidery stitches. And so I've never finished this either. Maybe I will finish it someday. We'll see. So here's one that I started and here's what it looks like. And we used to go to Disneyland all the time because we only lived a few minutes from there, and most people that lived around Disneyland had a year pass, so you could go over there whenever you wanted to. My husband and I at one time loved to do swing dancing. So I was really drawn to this kit because it was Mickey and Minnie doing a swing dance. I don't know why I haven't finished it, but there again, we moved so much, it just got stored in a box and was not found until many years later. I'm sure many of you get very ambitious and you have a tendency to overbuy. Not only do I overbuy fabric, but I also hoard cross-stitch kits and needlepoint kits. And when I was going through all the boxes and I discovered all of these, I was a little horrified with myself. So I know I need to go in for rehab on this. This is a small little kit. If you're interested in getting started in doing cross-stitch or needlepoint, start out with a small kit like this. So when you flip it over, you can see that this is stamped because you see the design already stamped on there. And what's nice about this one is all the threads are already sorted for you. Not all kits will they do that for you. I wish they did, but they don't. You can get these kits within a variety of subjects. This is a golf one. And then I love ones with shoes. I did one with flip-flops. And this one is a violin, so you can even get them with a music theme. And then again, this is Mickey and Minnie. My daughter bought this for me, and it got lost in storing again, but I do intend on finishing this one. And then here you can get them with all kinds of Christmas themes, all kinds. If you're looking for special holidays, you can find a lot of these that will reflect all of the different holidays. And then here's another one with flowers and vases and other items. Really, really pretty. And I also love coffee cups, so I do a lot of things with coffee cups on it. And here is another Mickey Mouse themed one. This is my daughter Maria, and this is a counted cross stitch project that she did.
Yeah, so I made this in junior high in the year 2000. I actually had a lot of fun making this, and counted cross stitch is something that I tend to gravitate more towards than sewing. A lot of viewers will ask, oh, is your daughter into sewing? And I am to a point, but I prefer projects like this over sewing. I actually first learned how to do cross stitch when I was a really little girl in daycare. One of the daycare teachers brought in all her cross stitch supplies, and it kept all of us kids entertained for like the entire day. So that's when I first learned and really realized how much I liked it. And I made this in junior high in a cross stitching class that I took, and it has the year 2000 on it, my name, the alphabet, letters. And my mom reminded me the other day that I got A-.
Yeah.
On this project.
I didn't even know she had done this. I was cleaning out a closet. We were getting ready to move, and I was cleaning out a closet, and I found this envelope on it, and the teacher had made a comment on the outside of the envelope, and it said A-. I thought, what is this? I opened it up, and I was shocked. She did a fantastic job. I said, why didn't you tell me about this? She goes, I don't know. And so I put this fabric around it and then framed it, and it hangs in our bedroom, and I just love it. You know, good job, honey.
Thank you.
Now I'm gonna share with you some of the cross stitch that my mother did. And she would do this for hours. Every afternoon, she would sit on the sofa and do this. Now, this is not counted cross stitch. It's kind of counted. This is on linen fabric. So you had to count all the threads, and that's how you knew how far to move over to do every little stitch. And it is just beautiful. These were all over her house, framed on the wall. And later, when she became very, very ill, I took them off the walls because we had to move her. And the frames were falling apart. Mm-hmm. and I put this fabric around the edges so that it would fit in to new frames. And here is another one. This is probably my favorite because I absolutely love flowers and I love the little basket. But look at this. I don't know how she had the patience.
She was very patient. She was very good at doing tedious, intricate, detailed work. She liked puzzles too.
Yeah, she loved crossword puzzles. She loved it. And here is another one. Aren't these beautiful? She has her initials down here. And I just am amazed at the patience she had. Now here is another one. Look at this. This is really pretty. Mm-hmm. They're all beautiful. I just am amazed at all of these. But again, we moved. I had to take them out of the frames to save on space. And so I just love them. And then here is another one. I didn't keep all of her embroidery work. We just didn't have the room, but I kept these because I felt like these were her best work. So I hope you enjoyed looking at all of these things, and I hope you enjoyed our little family heirlooms. I will be having a follow-up video in which I will explain what kind of kit to start out with if you want to get into it, and I'll show you some of the tools that I use to do this. I'll even share with you a little family heirloom tool that we have. So make sure you look for that link, subscribe to this channel, real important. And also check below your YouTube screen for other beginner projects that you can do, not necessarily related to this type of work, but if you want to get into sewing or learn more about hand stitching, make sure you follow me on Instagram because I'll talk about it in there, and check out my Facebook page. Thank you so much for watching and happy sewing.
Hi everyone.
I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click on the thumbs up button and don't forget to click on share to share this video with your friends. If you haven't subscribed yet, click on that red subscribe button down there in the lower right-hand corner of your screen. Click on the bell so you can receive notifications about my latest videos. I'm Cheryl, and this is Scotty, and this is Manny. See you next time, and happy sewing!